know what, to back it up, have all the information, and anticipate any questions that may be asked, because that doesn't always happen.
Well, but I said.
When it doesn't happen, it's embarrassing.
Make your appointment, because I will be in and out of the office for the next 4 weeks.
Mostly out.
Mostly out and in, so.
Well, I only have a few questions.
Check your calendar, then you can let me know your availability, okay?
Yep.
I'm just kidding, Chaplain.
I thought she was serious.
I thought she was serious. I thought you were serious. It sounded serious to me.
Margarita meetings. We approved you to be out of the office that frequently.
So that's all I have, so, whatever, Charlie, just let me know.
Even after this, if you have 3 minutes, the questions I have are fairly simple. I just wanna make sure that I understand. You know, if you're gonna stand up and you're gonna speak to an article, you better know what you're speaking to.
Well, it's all on you and Pam, because somebody's not gonna be there.
Somebody's not gonna be there.
First time ever.
Really?
Yep, first time ever.
Can I go with you?
I try.
Why not?
Anything else for general discussion? Items not really anticipated.
Yes, I do. What I would like to see happen, because I'd like to see us reorganize the board, do it now, so that we'll be all set after district meeting. So I would like to nominate Pam to take over the board, if you haven't had a chance. I've done it several times, Charlie's done it several times. It's time for initiation.
I don't know if we had that on the agenda. I don't know. That's an agenda item. I have no problem with that. In fact, I encourage it.
And we've got another meeting, yeah.
We got a meeting to attend.
I just wanna let you know.
Just put that on the agenda, reorganization of financial committee, board. You know, I just don't wanna vote on something that just wasn't.
No, but I want us to,
I have no problem with that. I certainly encourage that.
Well, was promised.
I have a.
Or threatened.
Hello?
Well, you're lucky you didn't have the one you were here on, and we did the Frank Housing rule. I fully expect whoever isn't there.
It's not here, it's not here.
I fully expected it.
I thought I'd die when Frank said that.
And the only other thing I have, I'll put it under.
I apologize, because I have people in from out of town. Hello? I'm just gonna call. I'm sorry.
They're trying to move out. That's it?
Three strikes.
I told you, I'm gonna be at my meeting until we spy.
The other item I don't know, I think the board may or may not be aware of, is that we now have another opening on the fire station building committee. We've had a resignation of one of the members. I'm gonna put it on the agenda for the next meeting. In the meantime, the applications that are on file, you have them?
Yes.
If you could, when I go in the office, meet with Mary on this, if I could have them, I'm gonna contact them to, I wanna contact them.
Okay. One does not have a phone number on it, so.
Does it have an email?
No, it has not.
Do we know the person?
I personally don't.
I haven't seen the letter of interest.
You have no contact information, now that's.
The other one has a phone number, and of course, Peter.
Yeah, I'd like to get a non-fire department oriented person, another citizen at large, because the person that resigned, the committee is a citizen at large. I don't wanna put a firefighter or.
Yeah, I think you should keep it.
I wanna keep the balance of non-fire department related people. You know, if we have no no citizens that are interested, then I have no problem with, if no one else is applied, going to a firefighter or a family member of a firefighter. I think that, the person was a citizen at large, I'd like to keep that balance.
But one of the.
It avoids the issue of having the committee look like it's a stacked committee of, you know.
Well, that's what I've been feeling with before, that's why we kept advertising and re-advertising, because we wanted the majority of the citizens as opposed to district people. But isn't one or two of them still the citizens at large?
Richard is a citizen. Lenny, how do you categorize Lenny? Is he a citizen or is he a firefighter?
Is he a qualified?
Well, he's still actively called firefighter, so he's a firefighter.
Even though he's a reserve.
Huh?
Even though he's a reserve.
Yes, I mean, he still attends drills and comes in on calls and runs equipment.
It's more, and it's just as much appearance as it is. Again, I just thought it was a nice thing to keep. When we went three times the first time to get the original committee, we kept re-advertising, re-advertising to get citizens involved.
Because we wanted it.
We wanted that balance, and I hate to change the balance.
And I wanted it to be out, it could be outvoted by citizens as opposed to district people. So there was like, out of the nine, they had one vote beyond the people that worked in the district, so that it would be fair to citizens.
And I'll contact, if we only have two people, one of them is a fire department, right?
We have three.
We have three, but one we have no contact.
We have no contact for.
Must be an address though.
No.
No address?
Nothing, just a letter. And the other one has a phone number, and then Peter.
Yeah, well, again, we can contact who we can contact, and if we can't find someone, then we need to advertise to the public that we have this opening and solicit citizens, preferably citizens at large, to apply so we can fill that committee. Again, it's just.
And that one citizen at large application that we have is still the citizen that isn't here in the wintertime.
Yes.
So they would be absent at the majority of the meetings. I think we need to consider advertising for citizen at large participation.
Well, that's why we passed them over originally.
Yes.
But how often are they going? I mean, looking at the committee where it's going forward now, basically.
They'll be meeting for next year and a half.
They will, but how, my point being, the Prudential Committee at this point going forward is making the final decision for the building coming up. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong, I've never sat through a committee through a fire station building, you would know more so than I, Charlie, that they would meet, but how much of an input are they going to have to say with the structure going up, or is it more on the chief as far as making decisions as to this, and it's more of the PRUCOM, are we gonna spend $2,000 for extra wiring for the Cadillac of wires on itself, but for wiring? It's all false, I think, now, I don't know, on the PRUCOM opposed to the committee.
Well, I think the committee needs to bring that to us to decide on, and it could get voted out in committee and not even get to us.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, so the committee would need to make that recommendation for us to say yay or nay. And it could be voted out before it got to us.
Say, I don't know.
My opinion is that throughout the last 2 years, Peter has attended meetings, not every meeting, but off and on. And I understood in the beginning the need to have citizens at large so that the community got a larger input than the employees. But now we're at the point where the site's been decided, the amount of money's been decided, and now you're at the point where maybe insight from somebody who's actually going to use the facility is more valuable than insight from a citizen that's
but
not
you have
going
that
to.
Insight.
I think we already have that.
From the chief, yeah.
We already
from the
have
chief.
That insight.
And maybe we need to think about, like you said, at this date, a lot of the preliminary work has been done. Maybe you don't need that to make that replacement. We might be okay with what we have now.
But there could be lots of issues that divide about it.
But I'm
fire station building committee would have to address
exactly
between now and when the building gets occupied.
Is it?
Yes. Oh yes.
Yeah, we still. Because
I thought that someone
no,
said
they'll still have plenty of decisions to be made.
I thought thought someone said that they wouldn't be meeting frequently, maybe once a quarter, once the building started. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong, maybe I heard wrong, but I thought it was like a once a quarter meeting, and they would have like one person who would be not like a clerk of works, but be here on a daily basis, checking to see what was going on and make a report back.
But the committee, and I agree, really needs to be on top of what's going on, so I think they're gonna at least meet minimum, you know.
Monthly.
They might switch it from twice a month.
We have an OPM.
We have.
He's gonna meet with that community, give them updates all through the process, you know, so, and then they are gonna be the conduit between the OPM and the financial committee.
They'll bring the recommendations.
So I mean, they will have things to do and decisions to make and recommendations to make to us, and then it'll be up to us to weigh the recommendations, you know, God forbid we should get change orders and that, those issues, and you always have some changes, you know, you hope to keep them at a very minimum, but they happen, and they affect the bottom line, and that's where the committee needs to be. I think an active committee is a good thing, and I think having a member of the public, we already have input from the fire side, operational side. We need more citizens at large that are making decisions based on financial and what they can afford versus, you know, what they absolutely like. I mean, a lot of things we'd like, but you know, we can't always get what we like.
Yeah.
We need to get what we can afford. So having that balance, I think, is important.
I want gold fixtures in the ladies' room.
You ain't getting them.
You're not getting the ladies' room.
Never mind gold.
Am I not getting gold fixtures?
It's called a bozo's. No, but I mean, why don't we go ahead and advertise?
That there is an open, and how would you like that? Don't you want that Matt to write an article? Do you want
have the chief be interviewed, get the chief interviewed where...
Yeah, we can have Matt talk.
Get the chief in.
Talk to the chief or talk to one of us in our committee. And I'll certainly explain to him that we had a member resign from the committee.
We should bring it to district meeting and make a decision after district meeting and see if there's anybody that's coming forward at district meeting.
Again, I think we can certainly advertise it. The sooner the better, as far as I'm concerned. I don't like to keep the... Let's advertise it. If we don't get any applications by district meeting, then fine. And then we'll announce it at district meeting like we did several years ago. But I mean, you know, if we wait now until district meeting and we don't get any feedback like we didn't get any feedback the last district meeting, then we're only that much further down the road. Let's advertise it now.
Oh, absolutely.
If we get somebody, fine. If we don't, then we will. You know, plan B will be thrown out at district meeting. I hate to keep pushing and kicking things down the road. Let's handle it.
Just for the record, I think you're looking for a letter of interest, and other than that, we don't have any other.
Correct.
A letter of interest to serve on the committee, correct.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we don't have an application per se, no. And anyone can write just a letter stating their interest in serving on the Association Building Committee. It'd just be nice to get a citizen at large. It would even be nicer if we could find a citizen at large who has building construction background that type of a background, but you know, even without that, an interested person can learn quickly. So, okay, any other items not reasonably anticipated?
I just had the one thing that I wanted.
Okay, we have a motion.
Whoa. I make a motion that we adjourn at 4:36.
4:36.
4:35.
Yeah, close enough.
Are we going out
tonight? Second.
We going out tonight for dinner?
I don't. I got to meet with you over this. My wife's going to Cozy's tonight with her girlfriend.
Well, there we go.
She's up in Waymouth babysitting the grandchild. And